Hi, welcome to our presentation. My name is Joanne. I'm a speech therapist from Sengkang Health, and together with Jody, deafness from CGH, we will be discussing about communication difficulties in patients after stroke. The goals for this presentation are to help you to gain an understanding of the types of communication disorders that may happen after a stroke, identify potential communication breakdowns that may occur, find out more about the role of speech therapists in managing such disorders, and learn strategies to communicate effectively with these patients. Speech therapists assess and manage patients with communication and swallowing difficulties. This presentation highlights the four domains of communication that may be affected after someone has a stroke: speech, language, voice, and cognition. A person may experience difficulties in one or a combination of these areas. Let's first look at how communication occurs in a simplified diagram. Say person A wants to tell person B about a new movie he saw yesterday. A first has to think about what he wants to say, find the right words, and string them into a sentence. A then produces the speech sounds using his mouth. Person B needs to be attending to the conversation. And then B's brain processes the info heard and understands the meaning. When breakdown occurs in one or more of these areas, we might have difficulty expressing ourselves or understanding what other people mean. Such communication breakdowns may occur following a stroke. Why is that so? Strokes could result in damage to language control centers in the brain, leading to impaired processing of language. These language control centers are usually located in the left hemispheric region. Also, paralysis or physical weakness in the face, tongue, or diaphragmatic muscles after a stroke could make it hard to produce and form sounds. The type and extent of communication problems will depend on the form of stroke and what kind of injury has occurred. The damage and resulting levels of ability will also vary. These are the types of communication disorders that we will be discussing here. I will explain their presentation and what are some of the signs that you can look out for when taking care of patients. Aphasia is difficulty in the understanding and or the use of language. While it influences communication, it does not impact intelligence. It may affect just one type of communication, for example, reading, listening, or speaking, or a combination. A person with aphasia may have problems following instructions, for example, when you ask him to raise his hand, understanding questions, for example, when asking for his name, give delayed responses, and in identifying objects, for example, taking a plate when asked to take the cup. They may also present with jargon, which are made-up words, perseveration or repeating the same word, word-finding difficulties, circumlocution, where they describe the idea, talk around it instead of saying the actual word, and replacing intended word with other words. A more severe form of aphasia, global aphasia, is where there are great difficulties in both the use and understanding of language. The second type of communication disorder, dysarthria, is difficulty with the clarity of speech due to weakness of muscles in the chest, vocal cords, soft palate, and the tongue and lips. This may impact on the quality, speed, and volume of speech. Third, apraxia occurs when a person has difficulty with planning and sequencing sounds for word production. They may present with problems initiating speech, and speech errors may sound like distortions of intended word. For example, saying tan alien as dam babia. In severe cases, patients with apraxia may be unable to produce any sound. Communication difficulties may also arise after a stroke due to changes in a person's cognitive functions, for example, attention and memory. These may be evident in the following ways during interactions. Poor attention and eye contact, forgetting very quickly, displaying inappropriate social behaviors, such as being impulsive or interrupting others, sounding disorganized or incoherent, changing topics frequently, and slow processing and responding. The patient may also deny difficulties, possibly demonstrating poor awareness and insight. Finally, muscle or nerve injury following stroke may lead to a voice disorder, which occurs when there is altered vocal quality, pitch, loudness, or vocal effort. An individual with vocal dysfunction may express concerns about his or her voice being unable to meet daily needs. Quality and loudness may be compromised, and a person may find it more effortful to talk.
Communication disorders adversely impact patients' quality of life and potentially even personal safety. They might have trouble expressing their basic needs and preferences, become withdrawn, face problems returning to work, and have learning difficulties during therapy sessions with other allied health professionals. Patients' families as well as healthcare professionals also face challenges. Family members may find it hard to understand what their loved one wants, and a nurse may have difficulties getting the patient to follow her instructions. Doctors may see communication difficulties impacting on patients' rehab progress. At the inpatient level, discharge arrangements will also need to take into account the patient's cognitive and communication status. How can speech therapies help patients with communication disorders? They provide therapy for patients in the areas of language, speech, voice, and cognition. Together with other healthcare professionals in the multidisciplinary team, they help patients in their rehabilitation journey post-stroke. The ST might suggest strategies for communication for patient and family to use, and alternatives to conventional communication include the use of iPad, writing, gestures, alphabet boards, and picture boards. STs also provide information, counseling, and caregiver training to facilitate communication. We can help facilitate communication by using the following communication strategies: making eye contact when talking to the person, making use of the appropriate body language, speak at a slower pace and use short phrases, avoid long and complex sentences, use gestures when speaking to the patient, for example, pointing to or showing them the item you are talking about. Writing can also be an alternative form of communication. Asking yes-no questions. Be patient and allow the person to find his words instead of rushing him or brushing him off. Avoid interrupting and encourage the person in social interactions. In the clinical setting, the typical nurse-patient interaction tends to be restrictive and more task-orientated. As such, these interactions are less social in nature. For patients with speech difficulties, this could further impede their speech recovery, as there are less chances to have open discussions, and they have very little influence over topics they may like to talk about. Nurse-patient interactions can be very one-sided as well, and patient can end up with a lower sense of self-worth. Hence, nurses caring for these patients have to be mindful and take effort in engaging these patients with more social interactions, and focusing less on task-oriented topics. Furthermore, nurses should take the time and effort to speak with these patients in a relaxed environment, reducing distractions and loud noises. Families and friends should be included in where possible, but avoid relying on them too much for translations and interpretations, as messages via a third person may get distorted into the person's own message along the way instead of the patient's. To conclude this presentation, stroke can result in speech, language, voice, and cognitive communication difficulties. These can impact negatively on patients' quality of life. Speech therapies help to manage patients with communication disorders by providing therapy, strategies, and caregiver training. If you recognize any of the signs and symptoms discussed here, please consult an ST for further evaluation. Thank you for listening to this presentation today. We hope you found it useful.